The next speaker is the Right Honourable Prime Minister of the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis. And especially because I don't know anything about elections and electioneering. And as the minister just alluded to, that there might be election in the air. And certainly this team, led by Sterling, CONTEC, DT, and Surrey, would not want to be ungrateful. We will ensure that we give the Right Honourable Prime Minister the opportunity to address us properly. So over to you, Right Honourable Prime Minister.
Yes, I think this is a good time, of course, to pass the mic, because we're talking about elections. I believe only I will be able to give some insight on that. Let me, of course, recognize Mr. Chairman, His Excellency, Your Excellency, Sir Edmund Lawrence, our Governor General of St. Kitts and Nevis, the Honorable Dr. Asst Management, our Deputy Prime Minister, the distinguished persons at the head table whom you have been introduced to before, Reverend Dr. Richard Gums, Superintendent Minister of the Methodist Community, our Chief Secretary, our Permanent Secretaries, Ambassador Hassel, and other members of the Diplomatic Corps, and of course those of the business community. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I too will emphasize that we are here today because on this very spot where we are now assembled, there will rise, I hope, not before too long, a tribute to Kitsian and Caribbean ingenuity. Indeed, on this spot, there will soon emerge what I am describing as an engineering and hospitality marvel that will be known as the Pelican Bay development. I'm very pleased both in my capacity as Prime Minister and as a son of the Caribbean to be a part of this moment. The moment at which CONTEC of St. Kitts and Nevis, Surrey Paving, registered in St. Lucia, and Sterling Asst Management of Jamaica will officially pivot from the months and years of careful planning, arranging, and preparing to the actual turning of the sod for the construction of Pelican Bay development, signaling the first of the many physical acts that will transform this space forever. As a result of what will begin here today, there will be increased revenue flows for our workers from various fields throughout St. Kitts and Nevis. There will be new income streams for professionals from a wide range of specialties and additional business opportunities for suppliers and service providers from across our federation. In addition, this US$89 million investment is expected to generate revenue flows to the treasury of some US$10 million in direct governmental taxes and fees alone. Pelican Bay, a participant in the Citizenship by Investment project, will help to stimulate visitor interest in the Federation as prospective visitors see not only what St. Kitts and Nevis has to offer compared to other destinations, but also the ever-expanding visitor options that are being made available within the Federation itself. Congratulations then are in order to Sterling Asst Management, to Surrey Paving and CONTEC. More specifically, congratulations to the men who have made it happen. Congratulations to Charles Ross, the owner of Sterling Asst Management. Congratulations to Leslie Chang, the owner of Surrey Paving. And of course, congratulations to Lincoln Pemberton and Troy Douglas and Ian Kelsick, the owners of Construction Technologies CONTEC. And I believe really that CONTEC in particular deserves a louder applause. Because it was not too very many months ago that this was one of the companies that had been severely challenged with the global economic and financial changes that we were experiencing here in St. Kitts and Nevis. And to a large extent, therefore, we wish CONTEC well, as it has been able to attract new strategic development partners in order to continue to serve the interests of the people of St. Kitts and Nevis. Let us give CONTEC another applause. We have worked with each other, and we have worked with them before. It is their forward-thinking and imaginative approach that led to the conception and promotion of this hotel condominium development, and we warmly welcome the opportunity to work with them again. My government realized years ago, ladies and gentlemen, that the world was changing, and it is doing so rapidly. Traditional donor countries were not terribly interested in providing aid to anyone anymore. Many of the world's traditionally strongest nations were experiencing severe financial difficulties of their own. And St. Kitts and Nevis found itself in that strange situation where, as our policies yielded greater and greater social and economic benefits for our people, the less access we could have to concessional arrangements that were created to aid weak and struggling nations. In other words, self-reliance was increasingly becoming the order of the day. And so in light of this, there was only one option open to us, and that was the option of putting our very best minds together to develop a well thought out, financially sound, pro-growth development model that would insulate us from the ravages of the global economic crisis. One model that would provide opportunities for the social and economic advancement of our proud and hard-working Kittitians and Nevisians. A model that would maintain this country's reputation as a well-managed, stable economy, as an economy in which, as the IMF and other international specialists at the recent Caribbean Growth Forum stressed, and I quote, "investor confidence remains strong," end of quote. This is what we have set out to do, and this is what we have done here as a people and as a government. In fact, I want to emphasize that during the time period when our cabinet meeting broke this afternoon and the time of coming here at this ceremony, I had a meeting with the team leader of the visiting IMF that is reporting on yet another quarterly review of our economy and its performance. We have seen, he said, a weak decline in economic performance for 2012 as was being predicted. And now we are set for positive growth, almost 2% for 2013 and beyond. I think this is important because we continue to emphasize that we've gone through a very painful period, but at the end of it, we are now seeing a rebound, one that will bring enormous returns and benefits for our people. The positive growth that is being anticipated now for this year is really as a result of a number of projects, some of which have already had groundbreaking, and some of which are yet to break ground, and some of which are continuing in their development. And so today, I make reference to the Golden Rock Business Condo development that has broken ground and has, in fact, continued to grow in its development. I make reference to the Emerald Gulf Residences, which also has already broken ground. And I believe the bulldozers should be on the site sometime this week, sometime next week, if not this week. I speak also, of course, of the Park Hyatt Resort that is going to be part of the Christophe Harbour development. And I have been told that in the very first week of June, this five-star resort will in fact break ground. And shortly after breaking ground, the bulldozers in fact will be on site the very next day. I speak therefore as well of the Koi Beach Resort over there in the Half Moon Frigate Bay area that is yet to break ground. I speak of the Silver Reef development that is ongoing. I speak of the Kittishan Hill development, resort development that is ongoing and which today employs over 300 people. I speak of the Ocean Edge that is also ongoing and the several other development constructions that are taking place here in St. Kitts and Nevis. And to a large extent, I want to emphasize that as a contributor to the 2% growth that is being expected for 2013, Pelican Bay development will also impact upon that positively. St. Kitts and Nevis is but a tiny speck in a complex global whole. Each country competing for investment dollars, each attempting to attract the kinds of capital injections on which all states, large and small, depend. And so we set about developing just the right mix of incentives, concessions, tax policies to make St. Kitts and Nevis a highly attractive option when compared with competing options. We committed ourselves to ensuring that the fiscal affairs of this country were managed in such a way, our civil servants provided for in such a way, and our public sector development in such a way, that our investors, whether local or foreign, after assessing us with calm objectivity, would feel fully confident, I emphasize, stepping forward to invest millions of dollars at their disposal right here in our country. This, as you have seen for several months now, is being done with steady and impressive regularity. And I just outlined the timetable and the agenda of development projects that are rolling out. And as a result of this, we are all here to commend and congratulate Pelican Bay developments today. That our hard work is yielding results, we are particularly grateful, because really what is happening in St. Kitts and Nevis is not happening every day. It is not happening, certainly not happening in every other country of the Caribbean. Certainly is not happening everywhere else around the world. Why is the attracting of investors so important to my government? It certainly is not simply in order for our financial statements to be in order, even though it is, without a doubt, very, very important. The overriding reason is so that Kittitians and Nevisions in all walks of life could find their socioeconomic prospects, whether directly or indirectly, greatly enhanced. And so I want to make a point as well that our local engineers, our lawyers, our contractors and others, for example, have been and will continue to be vital participants in this Pelican Bay project. Mr. Errol Douglas will serve as lead civil engineer. Mr. Douglas Gillanders, I'm told, would have served as our quantity surveyor here. Some 150 additional individuals will be employed during the construction phase, and some 250 will be employed on a full-time permanent basis once Pelican Bay is fully operational. Construction, I emphasize, is a major driver of economic growth worldwide, and so it is here in St. Kitts and Nevis. Tourism is a major engine of economic growth also in this economy. And so the utilization of local and regional expertise is a priority, a high priority of my government. And in Pelican Bay development, we have all of these right here. All of these three right here. And so congratulations again. I congratulate each and every one of you for being involved. I warmly therefore welcome Pelican Bay to our country's very carefully calibrated development mix. And I look forward to the years of positive economic activity that we shall all see as a result of Pelican Bay being here in our beautiful St. Kitts and Nevis. Again, I thank you. I thank you, Chan. I thank you, Cameron. I thank you all for being here for us at this critical time. God bless you. Thank you.